Welcome to Other Levels. In today's video, we're diving deeper into Excel to create a sales performance and growth analysis dashboard using Microsoft Excel. Whether you're a beginner or an experienced Excel user, this tutorial will help you master key techniques to build powerful and interactive dashboards. Don't forget to visit our website, other-levels.com, to download the templates and datasets used in this tutorial. Let's get started. First, we have our data table. As we've learned in previous tutorials, the first step is to insert a pivot table on a new worksheet to organize and modify the data dynamically. To save your time, we've already prepared some titles and themes so we can move quickly through this video because we value your time. First, let's calculate the total sales by dragging the amount field into the values section of the pivot table. To reflect this amount in a more visually appealing way, we'll link it to a separate cell since text boxes can't directly link to pivot table values. Next, we'll create a chart to display total sales by year. To enhance the visuals, we'll add the amount field to the values section 3 times. Changing the third calculation to show the percentage difference from the previous year. Once done, we'll move this chart to the dashboard sheet. Now, we'll insert 2 text boxes. One linked to the total sales amount and the other for the title. For a better visual representation of the percentage difference, we'll create a doughnut chart by using 100% and subtracting the calculated percentage to form the data source. Highlighting the difference in amounts between each year. We'll move this chart to the dashboard sheet as well. Moving on, let's analyze the total offers by year using a line chart and repeat the same process for the total orders by year. Both charts will be moved to the dashboard sheet. Next, we'll focus on sales per product using a column chart. Followed by analyzing total orders per product with a pie chart. Finally, we'll identify the top 5 customers and display their names, total number of orders, and total sales amount. At this stage, we've prepared all the pivot tables and charts needed for the dashboard. They are now ready to be redesigned and formatted into the final dashboard layout. In the next video, we'll focus on designing and creating the final dashboard, so stay tuned. It'll be ready next week. Meanwhile, don't forget to visit our website, other-levels.com, to download the templates and datasets. Thank you for watching, and we'll see you in the next video.